Fly a fair nation.
Fly a fair nation.
Thank you for tuning into the Pointless Talks podcast. I am Pointless. It is Father's Day. Woo! Happy Father's Day to all the fathers, the dads, the men in their children's lives. I have feelings about this day because I'm a daddy's girl, like through and through. When it comes to being a dad, my father can do no wrong in my eyes. Well, whatever. Deadbeats, find your children. Spend some time with them. The ones that's not financially supporting, send some dollars. Like, it's 2018. Y'all need to do better. Niggas out here getting their license suspended because of unpaid child support. For real. If you and your homeboy hit it, you don't know who the daddy is. Guess what? One of y'all pay 1 month, one of y'all pay the next month. They sell fucking, what is it? Paternity tests at fucking CV. Yo. All right, story. So one day I'm at work, right? And I just told y'all I work at CVS. Come find me. But this guy comes in, this older gentleman, probably like, you know, late 40s, you know, early 50s probably. And he bought a paternity test. Now, like 2 days later, he came to return it. And I'm like, the fuck? Why are you returning a paternity test? Apparently his son, or the child that he's trying to get the paternity test done for, did not want to do the paternity test. I was like, yo, that's wild. So I asked him how old Jit was. Jit was like 16, 17. So I was like, okay, he old enough to either not care that if you are not his father, still fucks with you as his daddy, or just like feel like you're a fucked up individual for trying to figure out if he's a daddy after all these years. Like if you're the father after all these years. I don't know. Whatever the case is, I thought that shit was wild. But if you are taking care of a child that is not yours, big ups to you. If you have adopted children, if you have stepchildren, you're playing the father role, the male adult role in these children's lives, big up to you. This day is for y'all. This day is not just for the people who have secreted into a person and created a life. This is not for the sperm donors. It's not for the people who, you know, like just waste. Like, waste, man, it's not for them. And woman, I'm sorry. Y'all gonna hate me for this. It's not for you either. Mother's Day was in May. This is June. This is not for the women who do both jobs. Because at the end of the day, as much as you do for that child or those children, you are still not their father. Like, I hate seeing these posts. I'm the mama and the daddy. I'm happy Father's Day to me. Like, girl, let go of that hurt. That baby is hurting too. They want to see their daddy. They want some new shoes. Whatever the case is. Like, they want to be able to say, my daddy bought me this. If you buy it and be like, you still not their father. Like, stop. I wish y'all would really stop, okay? Like, just be the best mother that you can be, okay? Like, that's it. And I always say that, you know, like, people who stay together for the sake of the child, even if they can't stand each other, it's real noble of you. But if the child is gonna suffer, get the fuck out. Like, get away from each other. If it's toxic, if y'all can't stand each other, like, no. Because at the end of the day, once you bring a child into the world, it stops being about you. Like, your life is, I don't want to say your life is over, but you can't be selfish all the time like you once were prior to child. You get me? So the people who don't pay child support, who don't show up for visits, who don't send no money, who don't do nothing, like, why? If you weren't ready to have a child, you should have pulled out. Wear a condom. Do, like, you know what I'm saying? I'm talking about the men specifically. You get me? And it's just, it's sad. It's sad because ultimately, the child is affected. And I'm going to say this, and some people are going to feel a way about it, but children need both parents. They don't need both parents to be together, but they need both parents, okay? If you have someone that can stand in for that, that's great and all. But if the child, especially if they know their father, if they know that the person standing in is not their father, like, some kids are affected more than others about this, because some kids can look at it and be like, okay, my daddy ain't shit, but at least this nigga stepped up and did what he was supposed to do. Or, you know what I'm saying, at least mommy held it down. We ain't need no daddy. But, you know what I'm saying, play step daddy, do step, you know, whatever the case is. At the end of the day, like I said, it's the child that suffers. But this is a happy Father's Day. Get your daddy the $9 card, the $10 card, you know what I'm saying? Like, what do guys like to do? Is there a basketball game playing tonight? I don't know. What do guys like? Buy him some cologne. Buy him a tie. Isn't that the cliche dad gift? I think I got my dad like a compressor, an air compressor or something 1 year. I don't fucking know. My dad be doing handyman shit. And you know, it's funny, on the topic of my dad, I feel like every Father's Day I say this shit about him, and people be like, why you talk about your daddy like that? My father is trash when it comes to relationships. If he is not emotionally vested in you, and I feel like that's just about every person, but my father is next level, okay? I learned a lot about men from growing up with my dad and seeing how he moves and, you know, metidesa, like, my dad carry on with some slackness, okay? Like, even in his old age, he's still carrying on in slackness. And I'm just like, yo, you're a trash ass partner. Like, I feel bad for the woman that fall for you, because, like, the only people you good to your kids, like, you're a great dad. Like, you take care of all your kids, you know what I'm saying? No matter who they came from. I'm horrible. But you know what I'm saying? Like, he takes care of his kids. You get me? Like, if he got to take custody, he will take custody, because he's not playing them games. He wants to make sure that the people carrying his last name are gonna come up in society and be people of substance and value. You get me? Like, he's here for that. My father one time said something to me like, he was put on this earth to grow children or to rear some fuckers. So I don't know, but I feel like Father's Day is also one of those days, like, even the dads don't even know it's Father's Day. You just get something like, oh shit, that's today, all right, thanks, you know what I'm saying? But I hope y'all have a good Father's Day. If y'all don't know y'all daddy, I'm sorry. I hope somebody was there to help you, you know, grow into the person that you are today. If you do know your father, if you have the opportunity to reach out and talk to your father, do it. Some of y'all are grown as shit holding grudges against y'all fathers, because when y'all were younger, because your daddy was younger too, he wasn't shit, but now he's trying to be a part of your life and you still holding on to that hurt. Let that hurt go. Y'all can grow through it together. If you gotta cuss this nigga out and tell him, yo, you wasn't there for me, you wasn't shit, this, that, and the next, listen, do what you gotta do. If you feel like you gotta punch this nigga in shit, I don't condone violence, but you know what I'm saying, like, get past it if you can. If you have the opportunity to do it, do it. Y'all holding on to grudges and y'all have the opportunity to reach out to people and y'all don't because something that happened when you were 6, dog, you 26. Like, this person has grown just as you have grown. You need to let that go, especially if they're trying to reach out and you just keep shutting them down. I'm preaching to somebody out there. I'm sorry if I'm putting you in your feelings, but let that shit the fuck go. Let it go, okay? If somebody is trying to make something work with you that hasn't worked before for lack of whoever's effort, let it go. Let it go. Like, let go the hurt. Let go the negativity. Start fresh. If you, like I said, if you need to cry, if you need to hash it out, write a fucking 4-page letter. Get it out of your system. Set the shit on fire, whatever the case is, and start fresh. Build from new. I mean, they say you can forgive, but you're not gonna forget. Of course. You know what I'm saying? But what is it they say? Forgiveness is for yourself. It's not for the other person. I'm still trying to learn that. But you know what I'm saying? I'm one of those people that I don't practice what I preach. But I give good advice sometimes. I should listen. You know what I'm saying? But for real though, for real. Like, if you have the opportunity to reach out, to make amends, any of that, do it. You know what I'm saying? Because you never know, like, what may happen. You don't want to live with regrets like, oh my god, I didn't do this when I could have. You get me? And not everybody's gonna live to be 100 like my granddaddy. I'm just saying that because I actually sent my cousin to go visit him earlier and he's just so cute to me. Like, he is just fucking adorable, okay? Like, my grandfather is the shit.com. Like, he's just so adorable to me. I love that man. But, you know, if y'all granddaddy stepped in and took care of y'all instead of y'all real daddies, love up on that man. You get me? Like, if your father passed away and you got some ill feelings, listen, if they passed away, talk to God, talk to the spirit, talk to whoever you talk to. Get some clarity, man. It's 2018. We almost halfway through the year. Like, these toxic emotions that we be holding on to, we need to let them go. And men, y'all can cry. It is okay for you to cry. Don't, if your daddy told you not to cry, you should try something and see if they're gonna cry. You know what I'm saying? Like, just toxic masculinity is not good for anyone. Point blank, period. Like, y'all can cry, express yourselves. Like, don't let nobody tell you that's a girl thing. Like, don't let nobody limit you. Like, if y'all do this toxic shit, if y'all have kids, men, if y'all have sons, don't do that shit. Don't do it. Like, I'm telling y'all off rip. Cause that shit you might think is funny when you're saying it and it might be said in a lighthearted way, but you might affect a child by saying it, especially if it's something you say repeatedly because your child is probably a cancer or whatever the case is, whatever the sign is, they're in touch with their feelings and they express their emotions freely. Don't care. That because he might turn out to be an ain't shit nigga because he was taught that he shouldn't express himself and, you know, feel. Okay, so that's my little rant, little snippet. Happy Daddy's Day to all the studs that, you know. I'm not doing it. All the Maddies, all the Dommies. Yeah, I mean, just happy Father's Day to all the fathers. Like I said, those who aren't doing their job and can do their job, please do your job. Those who can reach out, are able to make amends, do it. Just do it. If you can form a positive, like, if you're the reason that there is no relationship, fix it. Point blank, period. Like, there's nothing more to it. But we're gonna wrap this up. It was just a short snippet just for that. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Pointless Talks, Pointless Talks, Pointless Talks. Talks. There's no The Podcast. It's just Pointless Talks. Subscribe on SoundCloud, Apple Music, Google Play Music, all the other platforms. Give us 5 stars. Keeping a bad mind feelings them to in a self. And whether you got here on purpose or by fate, thank you again for listening to the Pointless Talks podcast. We out.